Hello everyone, this video we're going to talk about a related rates problem. Okay, so let's read it. Gas is escaping from a spherical balloon at a rate of 4 cubic feet per minute. How fast is the surface area of the balloon shrinking when the radius of the balloon is 4 feet? Okay, so the first thing that you need to do, you need to write down the formula for the volume. Okay, now the volume of the balloon will be V, let's label it V, 4 over 3 pi r to the third. Okay, because this is a sphere, that's why we have the power of 3 for the r, for the radius. Okay, so r is the radius, so the formula is 4 over 3 pi r to the third. Now, take a look at the keywords here. Gas is escaping from a spherical balloon, escaping, okay? Escaping from a spherical balloon at a rate of 4 cubic feet per minute. So what does it mean? When you're thinking of escaping gas, it means that your volume is decreasing as time progresses. Okay? So, and now, this is the second keyword that you should be looking at, the rate. And the rate is, when you're thinking of the xy plane, the rate of change is slope, right? The change of y divided by the change of x. So as one variable increases, the other either decreases or increases. Okay, so in this case, 4 will be your y value and x will be the time, right? So as time progresses, there's a rate of the volume versus the time. Okay, so this calls for estimating the instantaneous slope. So how do we write down the slope formula? Well, we're going to use the delta v divided by the delta t. So this way we will see that something happens to the volume of the balloon as time progresses. And we just said that the gas is escaping at the rate of 4 cubic feet per minute. So we're losing volume, right? The volume decreases. So that's why it has to be negative. So now we have to write dv dt is equal to negative 4. Okay? So negative 4. So now, how do we write dv dt? Delta V over delta T with respect to having a variable R and constants. Well, we're gonna use the product rule, okay? And also we're gonna use the techniques of differentiating, right? The differential definition. So we're gonna keep the constants, because 4 over 3 is a constant and the pi is a constant. And then now here's a variable R. Right, so r to the third will become, using the power rule, 3r squared. And now don't forget that we still have to have the dr over dt. Okay, so it means that the radius will also change as time progresses. Because think about this, if the balloon is getting smaller and smaller, the volume decreases, but the radius will also decrease, right? Because it's a spherical balloon, and just imagine that the radius will decrease. So that's why dr dt also exists, and we should include it when we're taking the derivative of the radius, okay? So now, so the delta v divided by the delta t is negative 4, so we can write it on the left side. Substitute this expression d delta v over delta t for negative 4, and then keep the right side the same, 4 over 3. Now these 3's will go out, so let's not include them. So let me erase that really quick. So we don't need that, so we're going to have 4 pi r squared delta r over delta t. So now we can solve for the delta r over delta t, right? Because everything else is going to be the same. So let's see. Basically, so delta r divided by the delta t is going to be negative 4 divided by 4 pi r squared, right? Because I'm going to solve for delta r over delta t, and that simplifies as negative 1 over pi r squared. Okay, So why did we need delta r over delta t? Well, let's look at the second sentence. How fast is the surface area of the balloon shrinking? So one more time, you see this shrinking means getting smaller and smaller, right? So, and that's true because as the volume decreases, the surface area will also decrease because we have a smaller balloon, smaller and smaller, getting smaller and smaller as the time progresses. Okay, so the surface area. So it calls for the surface area formula, which you should know as 4 pi r squared. Okay, so what is this asking us to do? It asks us to find the rate at which the surface area is shrinking. So we're talking about using the delta for the s, a, as time progresses, divided by the delta t. Okay, and now we're going to take the derivative of 4 pi r squared, right? And that's going to be using the power rule, 4 pi times 2r, and remember delta r over delta t, right? So now what do we have? We have the fact that we solved for the delta r over delta t, right? So we can use this value that we got. So it's going to be, let's combine the 2 and 4 in the product to give us 8 pi r times delta r over delta t, which is going to be negative 1 over pi r squared. Okay, so that's going to give us negative 8 over, and the pi's go away. The r goes away here, but in the denominator it stays there as the r, right? So that's going to be your the rate function for the surface area. Okay, so it will tell you based on, depending on the radius, the instantaneous radius, let's say, you will see how fast the surface area is shrinking. Because it will not shrink at a constant rate. The rate will change. Okay, that's why it's a function and depends on the r. So now, what are we ready to do to find the instantaneous rate? Well, we will use this information, right? The radius of the balloon is 4 feet. So now we can plug in this value. So we can say delta s over delta t such that r is equal to 4, right, is going to be negative 8 over 4. And that's going to give us negative 2. And that makes sense because the negative result means that the surface area is indeed shrinking. And how do we interpret it as your final answer? You will say the surface area is shrinking at the rate of 2 square feet, right? Square, because the surface area is two-dimensional, square feet per minute. Okay? Thanks for watching, and I hope this was helpful.